Is this a map? The land of the free and the home of the brave.
Well, in terms of general research, it started with Black life, early 1960s, late 1950s. And then when I had, you know, then when I do a specific person, it starts following with what they actually wore and pulling and trying to, well, not trying to, but actually doing some sort of recreating and putting things on them that would have been in their closet, their proverbial closet. The dresses that she has on, that Ife wears in the show, are very, very similar to dresses that I pulled research from that she actually had on. You know, the other thing that I wanted to mention is that even though, say for instance, Fannie was a poor sharecropping woman when she started, but the clothing that she wore, other than it may be a little you know, she wore clothing right up and she wore belts right up underneath her bust. So other than that, the dresses, depending on the style, would have been a dress she bought at Montgomery Ward or Woolworth, or if it was a different fabric, it could have been a dress that would have been bought at Neiman Marcus. Because you have to understand, the same sewing machine sews a $20,000 dress that sells a $20 dress. In all of the research I have of Fannie Lou Hamer, she was always neat, never dirty, never what you'd call disheveled. And so I really wanted, because quite often you'll see when historical African-American people or brown people, they're kind of disheveled and dirty, which would have been really the contrary, because if, say a Black woman of that era was making clothes for Miss Anne, who she worked for, you better believe she was making clothes for herself and her own family. And also at that time, you know, the people that they worked for would also give them hand-me-downs from their closets. So, you know, I just wanted to kind of make sure that she did not come off as, because she is country, but I did not want her to come off as, disheveled or dirty or sweaty or any of those things.